Hiya, Martino, Justino, to another State of Decay 2 Juggernaut Edition episode. Nightmare Zone as always, but I don't need to mention this. And this is the first episode after the update 16 release. I had the opportunity, like everyone else who downloaded the update, to enjoy this game in its newest installment, an updated patched version. A couple of hours, I recorded a 20-25 minute episode, which is playing in the background, cut together to, I don't know, a couple of minutes, you may see it. I haven't started rendering yet, but they released the update yesterday on Wednesday. It's extremely quick. I thought it would be on Friday or Saturday, but look at this, it was midweek. Because in the stream they also mentioned something about the end of the week, but yeah, here it is. The quickest updates I've encountered were the quick supply locker and swap of the weapons. So if I had, an example, Echo X2 crossbow, sniper crossbow, whatever equipped, and wanted to change or equip the scar, it automatically swapped the weapon back into the supply locker which was equipped previously. Then the community tab opens way faster, because in the recent few weeks I had problems, and many other players also, that the game was loading the community tab extremely long. It was like 3 to 5 seconds, not 5 seconds, but you know, a couple of seconds. It was like a lag. Then another update is of course the pawn shop. You get to the bounty broker and can start Chief the bounties. Jackson's, I haven't abandoned. Started that yet, because let me be Chief honest, Jackson. I'm not interested in rain codes, and the weapons are not interesting for me, because I use about exactly what I was 70% for. Of the time, like I used in State of Decay Yosi, the first one,
never saw Chief Jackson without melee this
weapons,
baton.
Especially bladed here, most of the time. Most of my community members and characters I also use close combat, like 2/3 of them. And if I use ranged weapons, I use mostly the Echo X3 repeating crossbow if I got one or two, or the sniper crossbow, and rarely I use the Red Talon weapons, not the Echo. I almost mix those two, and even those with professional breaks. But I also seen that other muzzle attachments also received the update, like the break, the choke, which has been increased, and of course the weapon's durability has been prolonged twice as long, so all weapons last twice as long, but the repair costs are also doubled, so it's pretty much still better, but it's at the end the same product. You have the only big advantage is that you can go longer in a longer distance and adventure longer and scavenge longer without having trouble with broken weapons, especially the melee weapons if you use a lot of melee, or the ranged weapon without getting back to your home base, repair those weapons at the workshop or, you know, at the supply locker. This is a big up for me. But yeah, parts aren't that rarely. I mostly salvage weapons, and even this is a point I also like, because I get now, instead of 15 or 20 scrap parts, now about 30, 25 to 30, 35 from a rebar, a pipe, a metal bed, a wooden bed, things like this, or even pistols I rarely use. No, I don't rarely use, I never use revolvers or pistols. And another thing I instantly stepped upon was, yeah, another fix. Like, I got 2 sieges in my base, and there was a bunch of community members around me, and I wanted to finish the Zets, and I wasn't interrupted that much by interacting with my community members or start a conversation with them. So the prioritization of Zet finishing moves are also remarkable, especially near containers and, yeah, chests, loot, I don't know, spots, you know what I mean, when you use the Y button, because like I said in my previous episode, the update 16 video I made yesterday, I also said that I use the standard settings without any swapping buttons, because it's almost the same, mostly like State of Decay 1 Yosi, and yeah, I'm used to that. Maybe I will try out the Guandu, I don't know how to pronounce it, this Japanese looking staff with a blade on top like a halberd, just shorter, way shorter, and maybe those Wyvern blades, because like I said, I use mostly bladed weapons or close combat knives, and the Wyrmling, that's how the dagger was called, looks pretty nice, like every close ranged combat weapon, whatever, you know, daggers and things like that, like stiletto knives, they don't break, so I think it's an extremely nice design weapon. I mean, each of the seven new added pawn shop DLC weapons, or well, not DLC, but you know, pawn shop update, are nice. But I'd also love to get some older bounties back into the game from extremely rare customization costumes, clothes, like the Juggernaut mask was a, if I'm not mixing it up with other items, was a limited time bounty, and a couple of other things like special biker vests, and I would like to collect those instead of raincoats, in my opinion, because like many criticized, raincoats are pretty much useless without rain, but the developer had a good point. They said it's to prevent the character from blood and gore, but nah, it's still not that useful because it's an argument that's valid for pretty much every outfit. It's also a thing I never put my eye on, so I never paid much attention about the clothes getting dirty or whatever, but rain or even snow would be awesome in State of Decay, because not every map is in a warm biome region, whatever. Especially Mayor Valley would have potential, and even especially Providence Ridge for some snowy terrain and snowy seasons, but that's just my opinion. Maybe they will add this in a couple of years for State of Decay 3, if we will have in State of Decay 3. The multiplayer has also been reported to be improved, less errors, and I guess the next few updates in, I don't know, whenever, maybe 3-4 months, will cover up more on the wishlist on State of Decay 2 on their homepage, because that would be awesome. There are a lot of interesting things about wishes from us, the community, the gaming community, and that's just my opinion. I think it was a nice patch. It wasn't so few, so little. So let me know about your opinion in the comments, and thanks for watching. Stay healthy, have a good time.
Infestations are way down. Thanks for the good work.